there were many new things happening. Ramona would be turning 8, entering the 3rd grade at a new school. Her father would be going back to school to teach art to other children. And her sister, Beatrice, would be entering junior high school. All of these things were exciting to Ramona. But what she admired the most was that her teacher would not know that she was Beatrice's little sister. So she had no worries when it came to her teacher inquiring why she was not anything like her big sister. Despite the new and exciting things that were occurring, she had bad parts entering the 3rd grade as well. She did not know how her teacher would feel about her, and she learned in the 1st grade that it is important to like your teacher and important for your teacher to like you. She would no longer be able to watch TV because she would disturb her father as he studied at the kitchen table. And she would have to continue spending her evenings at Howie's house until her parents got off from work. If anyone knew Howie, they knew that they would have to put up with his 4-year-old little sister, Willa Jean. And being nice to Willa Jean and not getting blamed for her actions were hard for Ramona. After all, Ramona is the oldest. This novel will show you that life as a 3rd grader can be exciting, but it is also tough at times. And the book is Ramona Quimby, Age 8, by Beverly Cleerly. The next book I have is Judy Moody Goes to College by Megan McDonald. I'll be reading a chapter titled Mom and Dadtitude. She, Judy Moody, had to take a note home, a note from the teacher, a note that said she needed extra special help, a note that she said she was hazy, not crazy about math. The top half of the note was just blah, blah. So Judy tore the note in half and gave the good half to her parents, not the bad half. Mom and Dad looked at the note. Judy's in trouble, sweet, said Stink. Only half trouble, said Judy. Judy, where's the rest of the note, asked Dad. I rounded it down, said Judy, to one half, like the fraction. Get it? I'm really good at math, fractions and rounding and everything. Quick, what's 12 times 12, asked Stink. None of your beeswax, said Judy. Try not 96, said Stink. Judy, the note, Mom said. Dad and I need to see it, the whole thing. Judy reached into her pocket and pulled out the crumbled up bottom half of the note. She handed it over. Mom and Dad read it. They read it times two. It took them about 1,000 years to read the fraction of a note. They talked to Judy. They talked to each other. They talked to people on the phone for 100 years. They came up with a plan. Not a listen to your new teacher plan. Not a hand over your brand new watch plan. Not a we'll help you with your homework plan. An extra special help plan. Eesh. A Judy Moody goes to a tutor plan. Tutor, said Judy. Can't you and Dad just help me? We will, said Mom. We will, said Dad. What's 6 times 6, said Stink. A tutor would be extra help, said Mom. A tutor would be special help, said Dad. Just like your teacher suggested. For your information, said Judy, Miss Grossman is not my teacher. What's 5 times 11, asked Stink. I'll listen, I promise, said Judy. I won't wear my new watch to school anymore. I'll count to gross and great gross. You're gross, said Stink. Judy had to prove she was good at math. She started rattling off times table. 4 times 2 equals 8. 8 times 2 equals 16. 16 times 2 equals something I haven't learned yet. But I will, I swear. Having a tutor would be fun, said Dad. You'll see tutors have flashcards, said Stink. Baby flashcards. What's 2 times 5? The number of toenails out. I'm going to paint while you're asleep, said Judy. Stink curled his toes under. Judy looked from Mom to Dad, Dad to Mom. Do I have to? It's already settled, said Mom. You start tomorrow. Hogshead, said Judy. Dad picked up Judy after school. The next day, Judy closed her eyes and slumped into the back seat of the car on the way to the tutor's. And she could see behind her closed eyes were flashcards, baby flashcards. She, Judy Moody, was in a mood, not a math mood, and definitely not a flashcard mood. Fact of life, she, Judy Moody, was a tutor type. Am I going to have to count beads and glue macaroni? Stink says I'm going to have to count beads and glue macaroni. I don't know, said Dad. Am I going to have to play with jelly beans in jars? Stink says I'm going to have to play with jelly beans in jars, said Judy. I don't know, said Dad. And I'm going to have to make a cat out of a triangle. Stink says I'm going to have to make a cat out of a triangle. Let's wait and see, said Dad. Maybe you'll get to play math games like tic-tac-toe. Tic-tac-toe nails. Judy made a mad face and slumped down in her seat some more. Dad didn't get it. He didn't have time to spend his afternoon doing macaroni math. and making geometry cats. We're here, Dad called cheerfully. Where's here? Judy asked in a moody tone. Colonial College, said Dad. College? Asked Judy. That's where you'll get help with your math, said Dad. Your tutor is a college student. Judy blotted upright and threw her arms in the air. I'm going to college. Judy always seems to have some kind of attitude with people around her. At first, she had a bad attitude when her parents decided for her to get a tutor. But now, she knows that her tutor will be a college student and that she has to go to college to get tutored. Her attitude turned from bad to good. Read Judy Moody Goes to College and see how her tutoring experience goes and how her attitude continues.